So on today's video, we are going to be solving a first order ODE using the separable form. But today we have an initial condition. So we're going to see how we're going to solve a problem like this when we're giving initial conditions. We're going to go through each one of the steps, and then we're going to see how the initial condition basically changes the problem. So the problem we have here, we can see we have the following. Dr over dt, and that's equal to negative 2 times t times r. So you can see this one, we already have, instead of dy dx, this time we're given dr dt, but it's follows the same procedure. And it, basically you can see we're giving also this term, r o and r equals to r naught. So basically it's telling us that whenever t is zero, so basically what this is telling us is that when t is zero, r will be equals to some constant r naught, which in this case is just another variable, it's a placeholder, but it's taking the place of a constant, so it can be any real number there. And this is what we call our initial conditions. So let's solve this problem. So this one, it's already, we can already skip the step of the dy dx is already given like that. So we just separate variables. So we'll send the dt to the other side, and we're going to get negative 2t r dt. We continue sending the r to the other side. So we're going to have dr over r equals to negative 2t and dt. Okay, so now we are going to integrate this. So we have the integral of dr over r, and this will be equal to the integral of negative 2t dt. So what we're going to be getting here, so for dr over r, we already know that's ln of r, and this is equal to this other integral. So negative 2t dt, that will be negative t squared plus c. Now remember, both sides can have that plus c, but in order to save ourselves some time, we already do it to the second one. So we continue with this. We're going to raise both sides to the exponent. So this will be e to the natural log of r, which equals to e to the negative t squared plus c. So solving that, we're going to get the exponential and the natural log cancel. You're going to get r is equals to e to the negative t squared times e to the c, which we can, of course, rewrite. And then we're going to get our answer here to be the r as a function of t is equals to this e to the c. We can change into capital C. So this will be c e to negative t squared. And this will be our general solution. So that was half of the problem. So every time we have an initial condition given, just like the one we're having this problem, our problem doesn't end there. Basically, what we have to do is we have to apply the initial condition, and it will give us our other solution. So let's apply that initial condition. So I'll put a note here. So apply initial condition. And we're given that when t equals zero, r equals to r naught. So in this case, if we apply that, we get here our function. So r of zero is equals to c e to the zero, right? That's our function that we have. So we're going to basically apply that initial condition into the solution that we found. So when we do that, You can see that we already have a definition for this, which was given over here on top, which is R naught. So then we can rewrite that as R naught is equals to C e to 0. And then we know what e to 0 is. We did another problem. So we know that this is R naught equals to C times 1. And therefore, we get then that our constant of integration C is equal to this R naught. So now I can write my final solution as R of T equals to R naught e to the negative T squared. And instead of being a general solution, you know, a solution that is applied for all of the cases, this is a particular solution. Meaning that this is a solution that it's only applicable in a specific instance. So for the general solution, we can have a solution that constant of integration C can represent basically any number with the positive, negative, and so on. But this particular solution, it's just a solution to a specific set of data, only a specific function. That's what the R naught. In this case, R naught is a general number, once again. But, you know, it could be a 5 or 6, 7, whatever any number you guys can think of. And that's how you apply initial conditions. And that's pretty much it. Hope this was helpful. I will see you guys in the next video.